Fox News legal analyst Arthur Idala, who has tried cases on both ends of the criminal spectrum as a prosecutor and as a defense attorney. Well, your thoughts on that, Arthur, how unusual it is that this prosecutor did not go in and argue for manslaughter, for murder, but just presented the jury with sort of the panoply, the grand jurors, the panoply of charges that they might consider.
Well, Megan, in the state of New York where I practice, the prosecutor's not allowed to make a closing argument. They're only allowed to what's called marshal the evidence. So you're allowed, especially in a presentation like this that took a very long time, at the end you're allowed to say, here's the evidence that you've heard, as I recall it, but it's your recollection that controls. And then you tell them what the evidence is. Then you recite the different laws. If you find by a preponderance of the evidence that on this date, that on at this time, he did commit the act of involuntary manslaughter, you can return a count, an indictment count of involuntary manslaughter in the first degree.
And then how do they vote on that? Then he sends them, I mean, how does the procedure work where they sit amongst themselves and decide?
Well, quite frankly, I don't know exactly, only because I've never been a grand jury. That everyone leaves the room. There's no stenographer, there's no court officer, there's no prosecutor. It's just the citizens who have been chosen on that grand jury who sit there, and there is a foreperson, just like in a regular grand jury, who's just supposed to, like, keep a count, and then they decide amongst themselves, and don't, you know, they have to be at least nine people
on at least
one charge.
Just stand by. I want to tell the viewers we just got the two-minute warning. So we will be getting the verdict within the next 2 minutes. The media is present in the courtroom. The prosecutor will come in, and we expect him to make the announcement one way or the other. As you can see, massive crowds now gathering outside of the Ferguson, Missouri courthouse, and we are just getting news in that there are already protests emerging in various cities around the country. The one highlighted here is Chicago, and we will get video of that for you. We have been told by police departments in other cities that they have been placed on alert as well prior to this verdict, preparing for protests, perhaps, no one knowing for sure what the result is, but preparing for the worst, hoping for the best, as they say. Arthur, so it has to be 9 of the 12 who
correct.
Agree. Will we find out what the breakdown was?
I don't think you will, and I don't think you should. As you said accurately earlier, it is a misdemeanor for the grand jurors to speak. Now, if you want to be very realistic, Megan, a misdemeanor, the punishment is up to a year in prison. If some agency, news agency, is offering someone $500,000 to tell their story, well, somebody might decide, you know what, I'll roll the dice that the judge isn't going to put me in jail, and I'll take $500,000 to tell my story. The one last thing, Megan, is there is an option in certain jurisdictions. If there is not a true bill, a grand jury can issue a report, and the grand jurors themselves can, like, tell a little story on paper and say, this is what we found, this is what we heard, these were the witnesses, this is what they told us, and this is why we did not return a true
bill. But what about the prosecutor? He's going to take 20 minutes of questions. Is he going to tell us what he understands the rationale to be? What is he at liberty to tell us?
He's at liberty to tell you, well, it's two different things, if there's a true bill or if there is not a true bill.
If there's not one, what can he say?
He can tell you the witnesses that he put before the jury, as long as he's confident that he's not compromising anybody's safety. And in what you're reporting on right now about all these people out there who are protesting, if I'm the prosecutor, I am going to be very hesitant before I put anyone's name out there. I may say there was a witness who was standing 25 feet away, and this witness said X. And there was a witness who was 20 feet away, and they said Y. But I am going to make sure I do not put anybody's life at jeopardy in this type of a heated confrontation that's taking place in the streets.
Stand by, Arthur, as the prosecutor, Bob McCullough, is coming into the courtroom now.